Hello and welcome back. So for today, I have a easy job to do. Maybe you have the same problem. And I will just change my waste on my bathtub. And I'm going to replace it with a pop-up one, which is this one. And it's quite simple and it's looking even nicer. Now I had a leak here, small leak, so I already took it out. This is the old one, so it's going to be quite simple to change it. So this is going to be exactly like that in this position. I'm going to show it to you. So this one is going to sit something like that on the other side. So is going to be like that, and then this is just going to be screwed in. So I will need to pull this out. Yeah, so, and at the bottom you are going to have the trap that is going to be like that. So all this is underneath the bathtub. So what I will need to do now, I will just have to put a new one, which is coming like that. Yeah. So I'm just going to unscrew this one. And here is going to be the trap coming. So it's going to be mounted like that under the bathtub. So I don't need this for now. So first thing that I'm doing, I'm just going to unscrew this. Yeah. So you have this screw here that is going to keep everything together inside here. You can use even a big screwdriver to tighten it up a little bit more. So first thing, I'm going to take this thing out. Okay. Then I'm going to take the washer and the overflow holder. So is this one, looks like this. Yeah, you also have washers and everything even on this side. So first thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to put the overflow. So I'm going to mount the overflow, which is going to be like that. Now it's tight enough, and then I'm just going to put that exactly at the bottom here in place. Just going to clean it a little bit first. Don't forget the washers, because then you are going to have leaks if you are not going to put them on. try to put it nice and tight. You can add some silicone at the back to make sure that you don't get any leaks. Okay, so right now I'm just going to put the back plate in here, and that is just going to close the waste, so the actual water is going to be blocked in the bathtub. I'm just going to check to see if everything is going to work. Okay, so it seems that everything is working. Okay, now to fix this, you are going to have a small screw inside there, so you just have to take a screwdriver and just tighten it up, and then it's going to be blocked there. So now we just have to block it into place. Now it's blocked and everything is working fine. Okay, so next I'm just going to put the trap, and that's it. Yeah, this is an easy job. If you don't want to use this, if it's not going to do the job, you just need to have you can use a normal one also with them. Something like that. Okay, so I'm just going to put this in and we are going to test it. See if it's going to stop the water and if we have any leaks. I feed the trap back in. Now the last thing that I need to do is just to put the, I will need to put the overflow connected to the waste, to this. So I bought a kit. Usually they are coming in the pack, so everything is it's in the pack. I had to take this one separately. So to put this one, now I don't trust them too much, so I'm going to put some silicone inside here. So it's good to have some silicone also prepared. I have it here and a gun, yeah. Ready. And just put a tiny bit around here so it can act as a seal. Okay. Okay, so as you can see, I already put the trap in and I just need to connect between the overflow with the actual waste. So let's just do that. Okay, so first I'm just going to connect it here. At the base, this, you just have to push it in, that's it. Try to put it as tight as possible. And job done. As you can see, it's not that difficult. Okay, so now I'm just going to clean up a little bit around here and test it. Okay, so let's do a final test. Now, I already put the screw a little bit higher, so here you have a screw, right, that you can put it a little bit higher and let more water go through the waste. So I'm just going to open it and close it now. Put some water in. That should be enough. And I'm just going to let the water go out. Now it's a good idea to fill all the bathtub with water to check even the overflow. Now the overflow is working, I don't have any leaks, so it's a go. Now, if you want to make it run faster, you can just take it out completely. Okay, so it seems that everything is working fine. It's just like a 10-minute job. I hope that this video is going to help you, and see you on the next one. And don't forget, if I can do it, you can. Bye bye.